welcome to Home and Family. Happy Friday. I hope you are all having a fantastic morning. We certainly are, and that is in good part because of the guy sitting next to me. He's our very special co-host today, one of our favorite chefs in the entire universe, Mr. Curtis Stone. Welcome, Curtis. We feel so honored to have you here today.
I'm so happy to be here.
Well, I know you are for one specific reason, not just because you love us, but also because I know you and your family, particularly your wife, Lindsay, and your two beautiful children, don't just love Christmas. It is an obsession.
I mean, you take it to a whole different level
in
the United States, which I love. In Australia, it's very chilled, right? Like, we have our barbecues, you know, usually during the day. We go to the beach. We play a little backyard cricket.
Yeah.
But, you know, my wife, we write the letters to Santa. You know, we go to find the tree. Finding the tree. Our kids are so into everything to do with Christmas. We have literally 50% of our garage. Yeah, I make some sweet treats, of course.
Cute.
We have 50% of our garage dedicated to the ornaments and lights of Christmas.
Only 50%?
It's a big garage.
No, it's a big deal.
Yeah, it is. It is. And we love it.
In Australia, I know. You guys are, Santa's wearing shorts, you're chilling, you're kicking it, throw some shrimp on the Barbie. Here, it is the one time of year that going over the top is absolutely accepted across the board, and we love it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you are bringing us a certain dessert today, all the way from Australia, that you make during the holidays.
We do. It sounds like a crazy thing to be doing at Christmas time. It's a pavlova, native to my Australia. I know it's a Russian ballerina, Ms. Pavlova, but it was actually developed for her while she was on a tour doing ballet in Australia. So it's a beautiful big meringue. We're going to do it with tropical fruits today, but you can do it with whatever fruits you like.
I had no idea about that.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was, pavlova's Russian.
No, it's Australian.
How about that?
Yeah, inspired by the incredible Russian ballerina.
I love that. And you make that, like you said, in the middle of the summertime because it always feels like Christmas in July.
It's sweet.
In Australia.
Light. Oh, it's fantastic.
Because it's always about 105 degrees. Well, I would like to let you all know that unfortunately today is our last day of Christmas in July. But we would like to remind all of you at home that you can still catch all of your favorite holiday movies as part of our Christmas Keepsake Week through the end of this weekend. So we're excited for that. And make sure to mark your calendars. Tell Lindsay.
I will.
And give her a little heads up because we have some very exciting news to share today. Our countdown to Christmas, the real Christmas, not the Christmas in July, kicks off on October 26th. And we have 22 brand new movies that we can all enjoy all holiday season, including Christmas Recipe for Love, starring our good friends Daniel Lissing and Brooke Dorsey. And we actually have a behind-the-scenes clip of the movie. Take a look.
Hi, Home and Family. Welcome to the set of our Christmas movie. We wish you were here. Let's check it out.
Let's go.
And action.
This is an amazing crew. Like, it's my dream crew. So we have a lot of fun.
When you walk on set, you're in this, like, little winter wonderland.
Thanks so much for stopping by, guys, to our amazing Christmas movie starring beautiful Brooke Dorsey and me, the very average actor, Daniel Lissing.
Well, it looks like I know what I'm doing this Christmas.
No, double. Mm-hmm. One of your brethren.
Right.
Yeah.
Brother from another mother. Get out.
Right. Daniel Lissing, also Australian, so you have to watch that movie. I know Lindsay will be watching. Mm-hmm. I bet your dog will even be watching.
Well, our dogs. We've got a couple of those beautiful mutts, and they absolutely love watching movies with us, believe it or not.
We have so many doggies in our movies, so I know they'll be watching. And speaking of doggies, Larissa has today's adoptable furry friend.
Hi, Larissa. I'm just enjoying listening over here in the garage.
Yes.
Do the dogs stay in the garage? Or are they in the garage?
Right. Do you say aluminum or aluminium?
We say aluminium.
Yeah.
Everything sounds so much nicer.
Does it matter what Australians or Brits say? They always sound just so... They sound smart, don't they?
They do. They can say whatever. Just keep talking, you guys. No. I'm going to take over for just a second, and then I'll send it over back to you. We have a very cute, adorable dog today that's up for adoption in Texas. Let me show you a couple of pictures, because the pictures speak 1,000 words. Because look at this guy. He's a mature man, about 10 and a half years old. That's his bed, by the way. He likes sleeping at the foot of the bed, so his foster family has actually built him his own little bed. And he is the cutest, smooshiest face you've ever seen with that underbite. So let's meet Lucky, that's his name, and Leah. They are in Texas. It looks like Lucky's having a nice little nap there.
He is. He's just such a great boy. He is just having a good old time on the floor here.
He's so cute. Tell us a little bit about him and his backstory.
Absolutely. So Lucky's a 10.5-pound English bulldog mix, and he actually was with his owner since he was a puppy. And unfortunately, they passed away, and that's how he wound up in our care. And he had a UTI and had a tumor that had to be removed. And now he's doing great and healthy as can be and ready for his new home.
And I know he snores and makes some funny little grunting noises as well in that video.
He's doing it right now.
And something else, I know you said he's not great with cats, but he loves other dogs. He loves people, kids. So for the most part, he'd be great in any home, just no cats.
Absolutely. He's just fantastic with all of the above.
Oh, he's so sweet. What a little cutie pie. And he sleeps in bed, I hear, as well. Is that correct?
He does, yes. He sleeps at the foot of the bed in his own little bed and just loves it.
And that playpen that the foster parents built, that comes with the adoption, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, phew. Or we'd have to DIY one here on the show. Well, thank you so much. If anybody... Oh, wait, I hear Debbie calling my name. Hold on.
I heard a rumor that Lucky, because he lives in Dallas, is he a Dallas Cowboys fan?
Absolutely.
Oh, yes. We definitely are going to need some Lucky this season.
Yes.
I think, Debbie, that means you need to adopt Lucky.
I think I might need to adopt Lucky. If I adopt him, I'm going to change his name to Jerry Jones, though. That's okay.
Oh, well, thank you so much, Leah. We hope that we can find Lucky a wonderful home. You can find out more information about Lucky at legacyhumanesociety.org. Again, they're in Texas. That's why they love the Cowboys. And if you're not in Texas, you can still find wonderful animals looking for adoption at all rescues and shelters across the country. Find one, bring them home, give them love, and give them the adoption ever after that they just deserve so much. Again, legacyhumanesociety.org for Lucky.
Thank you, Larissa. Thank you, ladies. And thank you, Lucky. Meanwhile, Shirley is standing by with today's Hallmark card. Hi, Shirley.
Hey, guys. Happy Friday, friends. Happy Friday. I feel lucky because I get to do the mail today. I love doing this. It looks like a Christmas card. It is Christmas in July still until we're finished. Oh, look how beautiful. Santa. Okay, here we go. This card is from Lena Kennedy from Chowchilla, California, and she writes, "Dear Shirley, I absolutely adore your cottage garden that you made, and I thought it was a sweet idea to make it Christmas-themed. Thank you. I have wanted a little garden for a long time, and you've encouraged me to finally get started and make one. But I want to do something special. I want to make it year-round. So I'm going to change the little cottage theme for each season. And I want to thank you for sharing your love of plants and your inspiration." You're welcome. Thank you, Lita, so much for writing. And it really does, you encourage me when I see that you take an idea that we present and you run with it. And I want to make sure that you please send us some photos or upload them to our Facebook page, because we want to follow up on your story and your project and the rest of you guys too. We want to hear from you. So please meet with us on Facebook.
Now, Shirley, my darling, you know I love to garden.
And yes.
You've got something special coming up, right? You're going to show
yes.
us how to grow hydrangeas no matter where you live.
Actually, it starts with an H, but it's a hibiscus.
What did I say? Hydrangeas.
Hydrangeas next week.
Guess what? You're going to learn all about it. And you will just going to learn about, especially if you're in a cold climate, I have a surprise for you. You can have hibiscus. Look how beautiful.
Look how beautiful those are.
Wow.
Thank you so much, Shirley. I can't wait to hear all about that. Meanwhile, our first guest is no stranger to us. He's been frozen in love. He has stopped the wedding, and he's found love at first dance. But now, he is here to tell us all about his new role in the Aurora Teagarden Mysteries series. Please welcome to our home for the very first time, which I can hardly believe, Niall Matter. I mean, it has been way too long.
It has been way too long.
We always see each other at all the Hallmark events, and I can't believe this is the first time you're sitting here.
Yep.
You have finally made it.
Mm-hmm.
And now you are in the new installment of Aurora.
I am.
You are Candace Cameron Bure's, dare I say, hunky new neighbor. It's okay, I know you. I can say that. We're friends. So in the disappearing game, tell us how you fit in.
Yeah, so I play Nick Miller, and he moves next door to Aurora, and he happens to be a psychology professor at the college, and his dad happened to be a cop. So he's kind of the perfect fit to join the Murders and Mystery Club, I think.
I mean, perfect. That's true.
And we've got a little clip from your first stakeout. So can we go and have a look at that?
Let's check it out.
Why haven't they come for the money?
Try to be still.
They could be somewhere nearby watching to make sure it's all clear.
There's a car pulling up behind us.
No headlights, that's not good.
Oh, Mia.
They're getting out.
Oh. Ro? Sally, what are you doing here? You told me you had to work tonight.
Oh, I turned in my story. Jason texted me, told me you guys were here.
Well, so. Get in. Get in. You could have scared the kidnappers away. Just get down.
I love this character. I really love her. I'm going to put it out there. Your character is perfect for Aurora.
Oh, I hope he stays around for a long time.
I mean, you'd make a really great love connection.
Possibly. Possibly.
I could maybe write the new one.
Feels like there's something going on.
There's
in that
something
car.
There. I could tell.
Yeah. Now, your third installment in the Father Christmas series is coming later this year. This time you're marrying Father Christmas. Mm-hmm. Remind us of how Ian and Miranda came together.
Well, first of all, we had Finding Father Christmas. That's when Miranda comes to Carlton Heath in search for her family or members of her family. She ends up meeting my character, Ian. They bond. They fall in love, and in the second installment, it's Engaging Father Christmas. He pops the question, right. Obviously. And in the third one, Marrying Father Christmas, we're going to see these two lovebirds tie the knot finally.
Finally. Mm-hmm. I like that. Mm-hmm. Maybe we can do Marrying Aurora for the next series as well. I see a theme here. Can I just say, by the way, congratulations on your huge blockbuster, The Predator. That
Thank
is a
you.
Big deal. I mean, are you so excited? Because I know you were actually doing double duty.
I was doing double duty. I shot The Predator for 4 months earlier, and then they came back and did reshoots while we were filming Finding Father Christmas. So oh, wow. During the reshoots, I was on the set of Marrying Father Christmas and The Predator at nighttime. So I was going back and forth.
So what was your day? How many hours were you really working?
I don't think I can say, because it would give me away how many hours I was staying awake.
But truthfully, a lot of people that don't know production at home,
yeah.
When you work hours on a film,
yeah.
There's no such thing as a 9-to-5. You work like 12 hours. That's average.
Yeah, there was a driver standing by that took me to the next set, and a driver that took me from that set back to the other one.
Not to mention, you have two tiny little kids at
I
the
do.
Same time.
Yeah.
Your wife is a saint.
My wife is a saint.
Right now.
She's amazing.
And to think you almost did not become an actor. He nearly became a farmer.
Right.
That's true. My dad, he tried bribing me when I told him that I was going to go to film school. My dad said, no, hold on, I'll offer you the dairy. I grew up in a dairy farm, mm-hmm. To which I declined. I went to film school, but at the end of that, I was in massive student debt, and I had to go back to Alberta, and I ended up working on the oil rigs until I had a really bad accident at 25. I rolled a rig. I was crushed inside the cab of it, and I got to the hospital. They wanted to amputate my right leg initially. Luckily, I kept it. It took me a long time to learn to walk again.
Oh my goodness.
I recovered and pursued acting full time, and I think I made the right call.
I think you made the right call, and that was probably a good reason to tell your dad this is not your calling. Like, Dad, I nearly killed myself. I don't think I'm going to do this. Wow.
But you still love going back to the farm and seeing those guys. And
I love going back to the farm, and for as long as I can remember, we've always had pets. I just saw the dog up for adoption there, and it reminded me of my German Shepherds growing up, because we always had them.
Always German Shepherds.
Always German Shepherds. Now there's a Husky in the family, a little, yeah. Yeah. So this is Rambo. That's me. A little. Oh, British Columbia. Foreshadowing. That's where I film most of my stuff.
Look at you. You're Towhead. You're blonde.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, and this is Cujo and Onyx. Those are our German Shepherds right now. They were so excited to see me. They knocked me over. That this is where I'm from. Like, this is like prairie land.
This
snow.
Is what it looks like.
Yes.
So it literally is like a Hallmark movie where you
yeah.
live.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, and this is Hercules. He's a little husky.
How old is Hercules?
Hercules is 9 months now.
Okay, I had a Siberian Husky, Sasha, 17 years.
Wow.
The best dog in the entire
and
world.
And so much energy.
So much energy. Whoa, she ate 13 parachutes.
Yeah,
I don't want to get into that.
On a day.
In a day, yeah. But I will tell you, and by the way, they're like the supermodels of the canine species, and
yeah.
They know. They're perfectly symmetrical.
They know.
The blue eyes. Yeah, I've. In case you haven't noticed, I've not gotten over her. That's why I still haven't adopted a new dog.
Yeah.
Because my heart is kind of broken.
I get it.
She's going to break your heart.
I understand.
Kind of like you break our hearts in every movie, but then you come around, you fall in love with the girl, and you always get her. I love you, Niall Matter. Thank you for joining us. Finally, You're going to come back, right?
I will. I'll be back.
All right. And you all can make a date for Sunday night when Aurora Teagarden Mysteries, The Disappearing Game, premieres at 9, 8 central on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. And you can connect with Niall on his social media page and keep up with that adorable little husky Hercules. And you all stick around. Niall's going to stick around because my wonderful dear co-host is going into the kitchen. And if Curtis Stone is cooking, everybody's going to stay. You're making your favorite Christmas dessert.
I am. I'm going to do a pavlova with tropical fruits, a little coconut. It's delicious, and it's so light. It's perfect for this weather, to be honest.
Come on back, everybody.